a jewelry armoire that I got online, and it's in pretty good condition. It has a few scratches on it. Nothing too bad. The door is open. Everything is nice and clean. That's the most important thing to me is, you know, if I'm going to do one for resale, I want something that's clean on the inside. The drawers all work well, and everything looks like this, so it's nice and clean. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go over it with some degreaser. I happen to use White Lightning. I'm going to take the hardware off, and I'll fix a couple of these scratches with some wood putty, and then I will use a bonding primer. This one is from Dixie Belle. It's called Slick Stick because of the shiny surface. I maybe don't need it once I go over it a little bit, but we'll use it anyway. And maybe I'll do a little fine sanding over that just to give me a nice soft surface. I taped off where I don't want paint and added tape tabs to pull the drawers open. I'll sand it lightly to remove any nits and then do a second coat off camera. Okay, I am going to do the second coat off camera, but I just wanted to show you. If you've been following along, I built a workbench for myself out of a trashed dining room console that someone was throwing out, and I wanted you to see how handy it is. So I have Aleene's premium decoupage. I want to say I get this at Walmart. Just a chip brush. And what I have done is I have taken a piece of rice paper and cut it in half. So I will use one half on this side and the other half on the other side. And what I'm doing is covering the doors. So just want to make sure that this is a good side. I kind of basically look at it and assess whether it should be going up or down. And most of these flora are kind of heading up, so even though this one's coming across, I think that's okay, because if you wanted to, you could hang it horizontally, but I'm going to go vertically but across. And we'll start at the top. I'm going to go each edge on the front to the back. And so yesterday I did a base coat over the primer with the color Celery, which is a Waverly color. And today I'm going to do a blend of several colors, and one of which is the Celery. Let me not spill these, if we can see these. I have the Celery, and I have a few different color greens, and then an off-white. Hopefully you can see that. And it's, I haven't even tested it. Usually I'll test it, but I'm gonna test it on camera, and I'm going to do the legs. Now, my plan later on is to do some copper accents, beginning with the lower leg. So I'm not really too concerned about how these little feet come out, but you know, I'm going to go over that, whatever ends up there with the copper. And I'm using brushes that I wouldn't normally use for blending, but only because they're the smallest brushes I have right now. And I don't want to use my big blending brushes because I think I would just make a mess. So I've got these three smallish to apply them and do a basic blend. And then now I will finalize my blend with my regular or a regular blending brush. And I have a wet rag over there to use. And yeah, so very loosely, sometimes I'll double dip. I'll use one color on the same, two colors on the same brush. But I'm not really, really, really going to worry about that. And I think I have my water, a mister. And yeah, so I'm going to mist this brush. And I think I'm going to start with a little bit of a darker green. Let's do a medium green. I forgot to mist my brush. Now you see how I'm just kind of like loosely brushing my medium color into the dark color, because this is, you know, a very loose application. And then lastly, I will do another bit of the Celery, and I'll just go over it with my blending brush, which is dry, so I will mist that too. And so this is just a barely there kind of thing. So I know I'm on the back side, so let me do, I'm gonna do the medium, a little bit right here, medium green on the other side. And these are probably pretty dry. Medium, and then I'm going to go with the darker green below. And then I'm actually going to add, I'm going to freshen this green that is on the same side as what I just did. So, whoops, it fell off here. This is the first coat, and I'm going to be very, very judicious in how many strokes I do there. It's a good time to wipe off the brush so it doesn't get muddy, because this is just the first coat. So yeah, let me back it up a little bit so you can see better. I figured this is a good video to talk about painted furniture, I know some of us who enjoy channels like mine are into painted furniture, and we consider it a style and finish. Painted design and finish on furniture has been around for hundreds, even thousands of years. I was poking around on eBay recently to see if I could value an antique I was working on. I reset the parameters to go from highest to lowest in price because I hoped mine might be right up there. I didn't see anything quite like my piece, by the way. But I was happy to see what came up as part of the most expensive pieces listed were painted antique pieces. Their paint was original and not much different from some of the things you'll see from furniture refinishers and furniture artists today. I thought you'd enjoy seeing these. There we go. And I'm going to do more of that on the other three legs and catch up with you in a bit. So that's my second coat, and there are still some spots that I want to go over again, but it's getting closer. I've done the legs from top to the, you know, what would be the bottom of the first shelf there, and it's not bad, but I am going to need to do a third coat.
2 a.m. and she calls me cause I'm still awake. Can you help me unravel my latest mistake? I don't love him. Winter just wasn't my season. Yeah, we walk through the door so accusing. Their eyes like they have any right at all to criticize. Hypocrites, you're all here for the very same reason. Cause you can't jump the track. We're like cars on a cable and life's like an hourglass glued to the table. No.
Thank you for watching this week's video. I got a pretty large jewelry armoire online and I thought it would make a good painting project and to fancy it up just a little bit. It was in really good condition anyway. It's nice and clean. I don't take these unless they're totally clean on the inside because in the off chance you couldn't get a stain out, that wouldn't be good and I couldn't resell it to anybody. It has the mirrored top with the ring holders and little bitties here and there. It works really well. It actually has a couple of places there where you can set it so it will stay. Really nice. This drawer is false. All the others, you know, they work really well. It has, you know, nice compartments and everything in it. It has the bottom drawer. I kept the same hardware. I just cleaned it and I went over it with a little bit of copper gilding. I like copper gilding wax. You can see the inside is really pretty. And what I did was I did a blend. Now the blend was really easy. I did all the taping off. It's a good thing because there's just a lot of details that you have to go over afterwards. Even when you tape it off, there's little bits of things that you're working and you touch something and there's a lot of like scraping. And I did, Restore finish on the fake wood that the rest of it is made out of. So I did decoupage on the sides and I did a little transfer on it just to be cute. I didn't put a lot on there, but just a little bit. A nice dragonfly in the back. I didn't paint the back. I left it original because it has that fake wood on it. What else? It didn't need any fixing. The blend was really complicated, not because of the colors. The colors were so simple to blend together. It was actually really easy. It's the shadowing that was tricky because, you know what, this doesn't have any shadow at all, so I'm sure you can tell. But all the rest has a nice shadow of light to dark. And the legs as well. I thought I was going to do just a very loose color placement, but then when I looked at the first coat, I said, no, you know, I really think it needs to be more like an ombre effect where you're going from the dark to the light or light to dark, whichever way you choose. And so that was the tricky part, is to blend all the colors everywhere before they started to dry. And that was kind of challenging. I decided at the last minute to do the dark green on the exterior shadows, and I think that came out really nice. I love the decoupage paper. It says tissue paper, but it's a rice paper. Really nice, super easy to apply. There wasn't a lot of money and materials with this, and you could spend whatever you wanted. I mean, you could do paint and lace. That would be much more expensive. You could do larger transfers. That would be more expensive. I think this is what they call a small transfer from Redesign with Prima use. And yeah, this works really well. You can see how pretty the inside is. The blend goes from light to dark, and it goes from dark to light. And so I'm pretty happy with it. I hope you like it. I hope somebody else likes it. I'll give you some more detailed pictures if you keep watching. And so have a good rest of your weekend. And I hope you have all good and beautiful things. And yeah, hopefully I'll see you next week. Take care.